It's really about being able to persuade people, about making arguments to people, about doing rational and analytical problem solving of complex problems, not just the science, but the logistics of how to get everybody in the same room, going in the same direction, the logistics of how to raise money, the logistics of understanding about business imperatives. And really, I communicate. I communicate to investors, to my board, to the lay world, as well as to all the people that I manage. When I met the first multiple myeloma patient who had been treated with our drug and who had a dramatic story that he had been carried on a stretcher into the hospital, unable to walk because multiple myeloma is a blood bone marrow disease and you have very affected bones. And he received our drug in an experimental clinical trial setting and then walked out of the hospital, came to San Francisco and walked the 3.5 mile race that the Multiple Myeloma Research Foundation was running to raise money. You do this science work, it seems very intellectual, it's very intellectually stimulating. You do all this logistic and tactical work to make the drug go through the hoops and to get it into clinical trials. You're looking at this data of patients who have responses, and it's all very interesting when it's on a graph. But when you meet the person, it's beyond belief. I mean, people were speechless. People were crying. It was incredible, and makes me cry now. And so over about the last year that I ran that company, I saw a whole number of multiple myeloma patients who had benefited from our drugs or from other drugs. And it put me in a completely different frame of mind, but it put a really human face on what we're doing. There are really still are not enough women who feel comfortable going into the sciences. It's still not considered, you know, a total norm. And if you want to rise up in the ranks and have as much impact as possible, then you need to have a great deal of confidence about who you are and what you're doing in the sciences. And in particularly in the scientific professions, it's okay to debate things, it's okay to challenge people. So you have to have a lot of resilience and realize that debate and discussion and basically people shooting down each other's ideas is part of the scientific method. But you have to be ready for that. And on the other hand, you also have to understand that people and your relationships with people and your personal connections are probably what's going to generate opportunities.